Good morning, Vananda. Today we are going to discuss about the flow chart for fast decoupled load flow methods. Okay, in the previous class, we are discussing about the derivation for that fast decoupled load flow method and also some problem that will be related to the fast decoupled method. Okay, that all will be discussed in the previous class. Now in the present class, what is the flow chart that will be there in the case of a fast decoupled method? Okay, how the algorithm that will be followed for solving the problem that will be related to the fast decoupled methods? Okay, and also I am giving the brief comparison between the Gauss-Seidel method, Newton-Raphson method and decoupled methods. The decoupled and fast decoupled methods are coming to the one category. Only in this power flow equations, the power flow solutions will be obtained by using the three methods. Okay, that is the Gauss-Seidel method, Newton-Raphson method and also the decoupled methods. Okay, the decoupled method is the extinction method for that Newton-Raphson method. Okay, in present days, we are forming the fast decoupled load flow methods. Okay, this is the flow chart for that fast decoupled load flow method. Okay, understand ma? Okay, this is the flow chart for that fast decoupled load flow method. Okay, by using this flow chart, okay, we will write down the algorithm for that flow, for that decoupled method and also the solve the problem that will be related to the fast decoupled load flow methods. Okay, first start. Okay, we can start the program and then read the line data and then read the line data or bus data. Okay, while observing the solution for that fast decoupled load flow method problem, first of all, we start the program. Okay, after that, we are studying the line data, that is the bus data or the diagrammatical form of power system. Okay, that means the read the line data, bus data, okay, the tolerance for that delta P and delta Q values. And that means that this power system that will be related, how many buses are there and which buses are having the slack buses and which buses are having the voltage buses and which buses are having the generator buses. Okay, that all will be read in the second step. Okay, normally we are having the how many terms are there? How many terms are there? We are having the four terms, that is P, okay, then Q, next magnitude V, next delta. Okay, these are the four variables. Okay, we are having the three buses are there. Okay, how many buses are there? We are having the three buses. First, bus one is the slack bus or the reference bus. Okay, first bus is the slack bus or the reference bus. Next, what is the second bus or the third bus? That is the PV bus. Next one is the PQ bus. Next one, third bus is the PQ bus. Okay, by using these buses, we can determine the power flow solutions. Okay, first coming to the slack bus, which terms are known terms? Delta V and delta. Okay, it is also called as the reference bus. The slack bus is also called as the reference terms. Okay, the known terms are the, okay, these are the known terms. Okay, this is the known terms, delta V and delta. Okay, next coming to the PV bus, this is also called as the voltage bus. Okay, this is also called as the voltage bus. In this bus, the known terms are the P and the magnitude V. Okay, these are the known terms. Next, considering PQ bus. PQ bus means the generator bus. Okay, PQ bus means the generator bus. Okay, in this bus, the known terms are the Q and the delta. Okay. In this bus, the known terms are the Q and the delta. Okay. Understand, ma? The known terms are the Q and the delta. First of all, okay, read the line data. Okay. Line data read means the, that is our bus data. Okay. How many buses are there and which buses are taken as the slack bus and which bus we are taking as the PV bus and which bus we are considering as the PQ bus. Okay. After the read that data and which parameters are known parameters and which parameters will be find out parameters. Okay. Which parameters will be find out parameters. Okay. That will be observed when we are observing the which bus is the slack bus, which bus is the PV bus and which bus is the PQ bus. Okay. This is the fixed for that slack bus and this is the fixed for PV bus and PQ bus. Okay. In that the known terms are the V delta and VP, PV, Q delta. Okay. And then the unknown terms, okay, the unknown remaining terms are the unknown terms. Okay, first of all, we can read the system data or the line data or bus data. Okay, after reading the bus data, okay, after reading the bus data, next, compute the Y bus matrix. Okay, next, what is the next step? Compute the Y bus matrix. Okay, what is the next step? We can compute the Y bus matrix. Okay, how we can compute? How we can compute means, okay, form the Y bus matrix. How we can form this Y bus matrix? The Y bus matrix is formed that will be depending upon the number of buses. Okay, in the given power system, okay, in the given power system, how many buses are there? Okay, first of all, we will study how many buses are there in the given power system. Suppose in this power system or the, in this given data, the number of buses are 3. Suppose the number of buses are 3. Okay, in this diagram, the number of buses are 3. That is first bus, second bus, third bus. Okay, suppose the number of buses are 3, then the dimension for that Y bus matrix is, then the dimension for that Y bus matrix is 3/3. Okay. Suppose we are having the 3 bus power system, the dimension for that Y bus matrix is the 3/3. First of all, we compute this term. Okay, what is the dimension for that Y bus matrix? And then form the Y bus. And then form the Y bus. Suppose we are having the 3/3 buses. Okay, we are having the 3 buses, then the Y bus matrix is equal to, Y bus is equal to the Y11, Y12, Y13. Okay, next, Y21, Y22, Y23. Next, Y31, Y32, Y33. Okay, this is the formation of the Y bus. Okay, form the Y bus. First of all, how many buses are there and what is the dimension for this bus? And then we can write down the Y bus matrix. Okay, after then, we calculate the Y11 term, Y12, Y13. Okay, first we are deriving diagonal elements. Okay, first of all, we are calculating the diagonal elements, that is Y11, Y22, Y33. Okay, this is form the Y bus, find the bus acceptance matrix B. Okay, the imaginary part of Y bus for all the buses except the slack bus B. Okay, that is of Y bus or the load bus. Okay, after calculating this Y bus, then the formula for that Y is equal to G minus JB. Okay, the formula for that y is equal to the g minus JD. Okay, y11. Y11 means the we are writing that is g11 and g minus JB11. Next, we calculate the y22. Okay, y22 means the g22 minus JB22. Okay, like that we calculate the g11 b11 g22 b22 g33 b33, and then g12 g13, and then g23, and b12 b13 b23, and so on. Okay, like that we form the bus susceptance matrix from the y bus matrix. Okay, bus susceptance matrix from the y bus matrix. Okay, this is the third step in the algorithm or the flowchart. Next, initializing the voltage state vector. Okay, we are initializing that voltages, that is magnitude of v2 power 0. Initializing the voltage vector, that is magnitude of v2 power 0, that will be considering as 1. Okay, that is the initializing or the flat start. Next, set iteration count. Okay, set the iteration count equal to 1. Next, bus number I, okay, equal to 1. Okay, bus number I is equal to 1. Then, therefore, I is equal to I plus 1. Okay, then I is equal to the I plus 1. Okay. Next, coming to the next step. Okay, understand ma? This is the various steps or the various stages for calculating the fast decoupled load flow method or the flow chart for that fast decoupled load flow methods. Next, calculate PI and QI values. Okay, then I is equal to 1. Then after I is equal to the 1, sorry, I equal to I plus 1. I equal to I plus 1. Okay, after I equal to I plus 1, then calculate the PI and QI values. Okay, what is that PI value? We are taking I equal to the I plus 1. Okay, I is equal to set iteration count 1, I is equal to I plus 1. Okay, then I is equal to, we are considering as 2. Okay, therefore I is equal to 2. Okay, then calculate the PI. PI means the P2. Okay, then we are calculating the PI, that means the P2. Okay, we are calculating the P2 calculated value. Okay, that is sigma I equal to 1 to n. So, sigma j equal to 1 to n vi yij vj cos of theta ij plus delta j minus delta I, where n is equal to the number of buses. Okay, how many buses are there? We are having the 3 buses, that means n is equal to the 3. Okay, therefore j will be taken as 1 in first, after that 2, after that 3. And then expand this sigma value, and then we calculate the P2 value. Okay, and then we calculate the P2 value. Next, we calculate the Q2. I is equal to 2, that's why we are calculating the Q2. Okay, therefore Q2 is equal to sigma j equal to 1 to n vi yij vj sine of theta ij plus delta j minus delta I. Okay, then I is equal to the 2, j is equal to 1, 2, and so on n. Why? Because the n is equal to the 3. That's why expanding this equation, this is the real term and this is the imaginary term. Okay, after calculating this PI and QI values, is I refer to PV bus. Okay, if we are taking the PV bus, is I refer to PV bus. Okay, it is yes. we are satisfying this condition, then go to calculate the delta pi. Calculate delta pi value. Okay, what is the formula for that delta pi? Delta pi equal to delta, sorry, pi specified minus pi calculated. Okay, pi specified means that will be taken as, we are taken as the that will be in the given question, and pi calculated means this value. Okay, the pi calculated means the this value. Okay, by using this formula we are calculating the pi value. Okay, then substitute this value and then we calculate the delta pi, and then we calculate the delta pi. Okay, after calculating this delta pi, then check for q limits. Then check for q limits. If qi is greater than the qi minimum, if qi is greater than the qi minimum, then we are going for qi specified equal to qi maximum. Okay, then calculate delta qi value. Delta qi equal to qi specified minus qi calculated. Qi specified is that will be given in that question, and qi calculated is by using this formula. Okay, by using this formula we calculate that qi value. Okay, then we are checking qi calculated is less than qi minimum. Okay, qi calculated is less than qi minimum, then we are going for qi specified equal to the qi minimum. Okay, then delta qi equal to qi specified minus qi calculated. Okay, if it is not PV bus, okay, suppose this condition is satisfied, then directly we calculate the delta pi and delta qi. Okay, by using these formulas, we can directly calculate the delta pi value and also delta qi value. Why? Because if it is not PV bus, okay, if it is not PV bus means that it is the generator bus. Okay, in that generator bus, the known terms are the P and the Q. Okay, that's why we calculate delta pi and delta qi value. Okay, understand ma? Okay, then directly calculate the delta pi and delta qi values. Next. If it is S, okay, if it is S means the delta pi is calculated, okay, this condition is S, then we are going I is less than N. Okay, I is the number of buses, that means 3. Okay, we are taking as I is less than the N. Okay, suppose I is not less than the N, then calculate delta delta I and delta VI. Okay, I is not less than S, then we are calculating the delta delta I value and delta VI value. Okay, the formula for that delta delta I is the minus B dash inverse matrix for that B. Okay, into delta PI and delta by delta VI. Next, delta VI is equal to minus of B double dash inverse delta P by delta V. Okay, this is the calculations for that delta V and also the delta and delta D. Okay, update bus voltages. Okay, after that we are updating the bus voltages. That is V new. Okay, we are calculating V new. V new equal to V old plus delta V, and then we calculating the delta nu. Okay, delta nu equal to delta old plus delta V. Okay, delta nu equal to delta old plus delta V. Okay, after updating the bus voltages, okay, after updating this bus voltages, then check for the tolerance value. Okay, then check for that tolerance value. That is delta pi is less than epsilon or delta Q is less than epsilon. If this condition or the this tolerance value is satisfied, if this tolerance is satisfied, then go to calculate the line voltages. Okay. If that condition, that tolerance value is satisfied, then calculate the line flows, slack bus. Then calculate the line flows, slack bus, power, total line losses, reactive power generated at PV buses. Okay, line losses, reactive power generated at PV buses. This all will be calculated and then go to the print and then stop. Go to the print and then stop. Okay. Suppose it is not satisfied, the tolerance value is not satisfied, then go to the iterate, that is equal to iterate equal to iteration plus 1. Okay. If I is less than n, it will be satisfied. Then go to the first step, bus count, bus numbers I is equal to 1, I is equal to I plus 1. And then continue the same procedure. If I is not equal to I is less than 1. If I is less than 1, then continues the same steps and same procedure. Okay, this is the flow chart for finding the fast decoupled load flow methods. Okay, this is the flow chart for finding the fast decoupled load flow method. By using this load data or by using this algorithm, we can easily solve the problem. Okay, we can easily solve the problem. Okay, understand ma? This is the flow chart for the fast decoupled load flow methods. Okay, like that we are writing the flow charts for that Gauss ideal methods and Newton Raphson method and also the decoupled methods. First, Gauss ideal method. Okay. Some of the advantages and disadvantages are there in the Gauss ideal methods. Okay, that will be discussed. First, what are the advantages and disadvantages are there in the Gauss ideal methods? Okay, this is the last topic in the second unit, that is the power flow solutions. Okay, what are the advantages are there in the Gauss ideal methods? Coming to the advantages, it is a simple technique. Okay, GS method is the simple technique. The computer memory requires is the less. Okay, the memory for that computer, that stored memory is less in the case of a Gauss ideal methods. Okay, less computational time per iterations. Okay, we are taking the less time for the computation of the iterations. Okay, these are the advantages in the case of a Gauss ideal methods. Okay, what are the disadvantages are there? That is the slow rate of convergence. The convergence operation is slow in the case of GR method. Therefore, large number of iterations are required. Okay, as the number of buses is increases, number of iterations is also increases. Okay, if the number of iterations are increases, the space for that memory is also increases and the time taking process. Okay, these are the some of the disadvantages in the case of a Gauss ideal methods. Next, coming to the Newton Raphson method. Okay, in the Newton Raphson method, what what are the main advantages and disadvantages are there? Means in the Newton-Raphson method, the advantages is the convergency process is better when compared to the GR method. Okay, while using the Newton-Raphson method, we are requiring the less iterations. Okay, in the case of Gauss-Seidel methods, we are requiring the more iterations, but while we are using the Newton-Raphson method, the iterations are reduced. Okay, the number of iterations required is less. Therefore, the number of iterations is independent of the system size. Okay, the load flow solutions of a large power systems. Okay, this Newton-Raphson method is suitable in the case of a large power systems. In large power systems, we are using the NR method. Why? Because means that we require the less iterations. Okay, that's why in the large power systems are, while calculating the large power flow calculations, in that case, we are using the NR method. Next, what are the disadvantages are there in the NR method? Okay, coming to the disadvantages, the solution technique is difficult. Okay, in the case of NR method, the solution process is difficult. Okay, that means in that we are using the number of partial differentiations for determining the Jacobian matrix. Okay, we are requiring the partial differentiations. Okay, then the calculations process is difficult in case of a Newton-Raphson methods. Okay, for finding the Jacobian matrix, we are using the partial differentiations. Okay, therefore, the solution for that problem is somewhat difficult. Next, calculations in each iterations is more. Okay, each and every iterations, we are requiring the more calculations. Okay, each and every iterations, we are requiring the more iterations. Next, computational time is more. In the case of a Newton-Raphson method, the computational time required is the more, and memory required is also large. Why? Because means we are storing the number of partial differentiation equations and then Jacobian matrix terms, then the memory required for the Newton-Raphson method is more. Okay. In this Newton-Raphson method, the one of the major advantage is the number of iterations are reduced. Okay, the major advantage is the number of iterations are reduced. Next, coming to the comparison between the Gauss-Seidel method, Newton-Raphson method and fast decoupled load flow methods. Okay, first, coming to the first one, it requires the large number of iterations to reach convergency. In the Gauss-Seidel method, we are requiring the large number of iterations. Okay, we are requiring the large number of iterations for reaching the convergency. Okay, while in the case of a Newton-Raphson method, requires less number of iterations. Okay, requires less number of iterations. Next, coming to the fast decoupled method, requires more number of iterations than the Newton-Raphson method. Okay, it will be reduced when compared to the Gauss-Seidel method, but when compared to the Newton-Raphson method, it requires more iterations. Okay, next, coming to the second comparison, computation time for iterations is less. Okay, the time for that iterations in the Gauss-Seidel method is less. Okay, the time for the iteration for that Gauss-Seidel method is the less. Okay, next, computational time for iterations is more in the Newton-Raphson method. Okay, we are requiring the less number of iterations, but the time required for that iteration process is more. Okay, the time required for that iteration process is more. Next, computation time for iterations is less. Okay, in the fast decoupled method, iterations time is also less. Okay, next, coming to the third comparison, that is, it has linear convergency characteristics. Okay, coming to the third third method, that is, it has the linear convergency characteristics. The Gauss ideal method has linear convergency characteristics. Next, in the Newton-Raphson method, it has the quadratic convergency characteristics. Gauss ideal method having the linear characteristics, Newton-Raphson method having the quadrature convergency characteristics. Okay, next, coming to the fourth comparison, that is, the number of iterations required for convergency increases. Okay, number of iterations required for convergency is increases with the size of the system. Suppose the size of the power system is increased, then the iterations are also increases. Okay, the number of iterations are independent of the size. Okay, in the Newton-Raphson method, suppose the power system size will be increased, okay, it will be independent of the iterations. Okay, in the fast decoupled load flow method, the number of iterations are does not depending of the size. Okay, it does not depending upon the size also. Okay, next, coming to the fifth comparison. Less memory is required. Okay, coming to the fifth comparison. Okay, we are requiring the less memory. Okay, less memory requirements. And in the Newton-Raphson method, we are requiring the more memories. More memory for the storage of this iteration process. Okay, fast decoupled method is also the less memory. Okay, this is the comparisons for that Gauss ideal method, Newton-Raphson method, and fast. These are the three methods for solving the power flow equations. That is the Gauss ideal method, Newton-Raphson method, and fast decoupled method. Okay, each and every method having the some derivation part and flow chart. Derivation part, flow chart, and also the algorithm and the solution for that problems. Okay, this is the totally second unit. Okay, the second unit consisting of four topics, that is Gauss ideal method, Newton-Raphson method, and also decoupled method and fast decoupled method. Okay, we are studying the derivation for that Gauss ideal method and flow chart and then problem. Similarly, we are studying the Newton-Raphson method derivation and flow chart for that Newton-Raphson method.